And you're looking live inside the Richmond Coliseum for tonight's championship game is on the line. It's the regular season champions, the 49ers of UNCC, taking on the homestanding Rams of Virginia Commonwealth University. Hi, everybody. This is Bob Rathbun. Alongside Dick Vitale as we get set for this championship game. And Dick, the VCU Rams come in as the number two seed, and they'll be looking on those broad shoulders of Phil Stinnie for some success tonight.
Bob, they really go as Mr. Stinnie goes. When you talk about Virginia Commonwealth, you talk about a team that won the first two outings between these two clubs. Stinney's an outstanding shooter. They have a pride down in Richmond, Virginia. They say he's player of the year. But they say over at, well, in Charlotte country, they say, no, baby, the player of the year is Byron Dinkins, who's had a phenomenal year.
That gets us to UNCC. They were the regular season champions, and indeed, Byron Dinkins was named the Sun Belt Player of the Year. He had a whale of a season.
Well, he's a slashing player. He's got great quickness. Jeff Mullins tells me he's a great story. Came out of high school when he was not heavily recruited. He was a player that didn't have a great deal of size. He was only like about 140 pounds. He's built himself up. He can score. He's a slashing player. Hey, we got a matchup, 49ers and Rams. It's not Bill Walsh going against John Robinson. It's Jeff Mullins against Mike Polio, and what a matchup. And the big dance, baby, is what they want. They want the NCAA tournament.
That's at stake tonight here in Richmond, Virginia. Now let's go back to Bob Lee. Well, Dick Vitale, this is an interesting matchup between these two Sun Belt teams, UNCC and VCU. The 49ers won the regular season, but during the season, they lost two games to VCU.
Well, they lost to VCU because they had a very difficult time rebounding. Jeff Mullins told me he's very concerned about the rebounding power of VCU. They really hit him on the offensive boards. In their last meeting, they had 24 offensive rebounds. You know what's interesting? You look at Charlotte, they have won 11 of their last 13 games. Their only two losses have been to the Rams.
That's our matchup, UNCC and VCU, the lineups in a moment. Back at Richmond, let's meet the starting lineups. And for those, public address announcer Hunter Elliott.
A most cordial good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Richmond Coliseum for the finest in college basketball. Tonight's championship game of the Sun Belt Conference Tournament features the visiting Rams of Virginia Commonwealth University and the 49ers of the University of North Carolina at Charlotte. Introducing tonight's starting lineups, first for the visiting VCU Rams. At one forward, a 6'8" senior from Charlottesville, Virginia, number 35, Phil Stinnie. At the other forward, a 6'7" senior from Brunswick, Virginia, number 32, John Thompson. At the center position, a 6'7" senior from Birmingham, Alabama, number 52, Bruce Petway. At one guard, a 6'3" junior from Sumter, South Carolina, number 30, Vince Wilson. And at the other guard, a 6'4" junior from our nation's capital, number 45, Chris Cheeks. And the head coach of the Rams, Mike Polio. And now for the UNC Charlotte 49ers. At one forward, a 6'5" sophomore from Georgetown, Kentucky, number 35, Frank Pursley. At the other forward, a 6'8" sophomore from Worcester, Massachusetts, number 44, Cedric Ball. At center, a 6'8" senior from Dubuque, Iowa, number 45, Dan Plonke. At one guard, a 6'2" junior from Charlotte, North Carolina, number 4, Byron Dinkins. And at the other guard, a 6'3" junior from Bermuda Run, North Carolina, number 11, Jeff West. and the head coach of the 49ers, Mr. Jeff Mullins.
UNCC, the host team on the, as far as the city's concerned, that's why they're in white, VCU in black, the tip coming up. Back at the Richmond Coliseum, Sun Belt Conference tournament game, here are the officials. On the left, Don Ferguson, in the middle, Don Rutledge, and on the right, it is Jake Bell. Here are the keys to winning, Dick Vitale.
Well, they're going to neutralize the rebounding power right now. Stinnie does a great job on the boards, and they're going to have to neutralize that rebounding power if they want to win. Number two, they're going to have to contain Cheeks and all the complementary players. They can't allow those complementary players to dominate.
For VCU.
Well, for VCU, they're going to have to control Dinkins out of the perimeter. They can't allow him to control the game, and he's capable of doing that. On the interior, inside and outside. They got an outstanding tandem when they talk about those two. The D&P gang, Dinkins and Plotke.
Here are the regular season matchups. VCU winning both in Charlotte and on this floor. In fact, VCU has never lost to UNCC here at the Richmond Coliseum. They are 10-0 against the 49ers here.
Well, they've won their
overall standings.
They've won their last two games here, not against certainly VCU, but at least they got the feeling they can win here.
Here's the opening tip, and it's won by UNCC. Cedric Ball back to Byron Dinkins. The 49ers come in with 21 victories and 8 defeats. They've won 11 of their last 13, the two losses to VCU.
Man-to-man defense right now.
Cedric Ball. Plotke keeps it alive. Dinkins has it, and the 49ers control. A big key, Dick, for UNCC to get those early offensive rebounds.
Cedric Ball is a very emotional player. If he can get a good start, we'll help him.
Dinkins short on the three-pointer. Pursley follows and misses. And a foul on Frank Pursley.
That really hurts. You have four opportunities, and you can't get a score. Pursley, a key player. He's a good defensive player, very physical. There's the little jumper. There's an opportunity right here, but there's Pursley, number 35. He's nailed.
Here come the VCU Rams. Under Coach Mike Folio, winners of 21, losers of 10. And a whistle on the baseline, and Stinnie stepped down the end line, and that gives the ball over to UNCC.
There's a lot of enthusiasm here today. It started real early as we look at Mike Folio. We watched him at practice today, and he was reminding Mr. Stinnie constantly, you weren't player of the year. It was Mr. Dinkins.
Dinkins fitting inside the ball too long, intercepted by Thompson. Here's Chris Cheeks. Blocked by West, he got a piece of the arm, and that'll be a personal foul. Still looking for the first points of the game, and Chris Cheeks will shoot two.
Cheeks has really played well. They have a very deep backcourt. They really rely on their backcourt. The Rams of VCU can go four deep there in that backcourt, Bob.
That they can, and Cheeks, the top scorer out of the backcourt foursome. He's averaging 17.2 a game, eighth best in the Sun Belt, and he scored 28 points in two tournament games.
He's a driver. He can also pass the ball, shoot well. He's playing as well as any guard right now on their ball club. I remember the tradition and the history of VCU, and they've always had some great guards. Remember Edmund Sherrard and a guy by the name of Gerald Henderson?
Oh, yes.
Henderson's bounced around the NBA. He's now with the 76ers.
Jakes puts VCU on top, 2-0.
Here comes the trap. Throw right over the top.
Frank Pursley pulls the trigger on a 14-footer. Petway the rebound. Oh, the 49ers are ice cold here to start the game.
Petway, big and strong, is a transfer from out of Alabama. Played for Wim Sanderson and then decided to go here. Get some playing time.
Phil Stinnie.
Stinnie, a good shooter. They believe he's the MVP, but the coaches voted for Mr. Dinkins. The 35, watch Stinnie inside.
Stinnie rolls it over the rim. Dinkins the rebound. Dinkins is going to go to the bucket and draws the foul. It's a clock on VCU's Vince Wilson.
Stinnie is a good open court. Dinkins is a good open court player. Dinkins can get the ball and go coast to coast. Watch the little guy right now. He's 6'1". He's got a lot of shake and bake in him. There's no doubt he wants to go right down. There's the block. Defensive player is not there.
Dick, you were mentioning the tradition of VCU. Certainly the tradition of UNCC getting the Sun Belt off and flying. The first year of the league, the 49ers went to the Final Four.
12 years ago, 1976-77, they had a career player by the name of Cornbread Maxwell.
The pride of Kinston, North Carolina.
And they took Marquette right to the buzzer. It was a pass to Jerome Whitehead to beat them.
Jeff West on a three-pointer puts the 49ers on top.
He's a long-range shooter. He's a streaky shooter. He's got an excellent touch. Last year, he was injured earlier in the year, missed 10 games with a bone fracture. Oh, I thought a little walking violation.
But Cheeks gets the basket. 4-3 VCU.
We talk about Cheeks being a driver. No one rotated over to give any kind of help to take away his driving lane. Watch number four. He's very quick with the ball.
Cedric Ball took an extra step. That's a turnover, giving it over to VCU.
Well, it was a good two-man play. They worked at that on the shoot-around today, Jeff Mullins, and they executed, except Mr. Ball lifts that pivot foot.
17-20 left in the first half, and a 4-3 lead for VCU.
Man-to-man defense. They want to really give a lot of help and take away the driving lane.
Stinnie, short, rebound to West. Taken away by Thompson. Cheeks, three-pointer. The ball belongs to UNCC.
Take a look at Jeff Mullins, the former All-American. What a career he had as a player. Mr. Basketball in Kentucky. He was a two-time Duke All-American under Vic Bubas, the commissioner of the Sun Belt Conference. He played with the Golden State Warriors in 75 when he won the World Championship. Now he's an AD and a coach.
Dinkins, air ball.
Little cry of air ball, Mr. Dinkins. Nobody really wanted him out of high school. Came out of Charlotte, North Carolina.
Mike Washington is coming into the ball game now for the 49ers. Big 6'6 junior. Adds a little beef to that 49er front line.
He's very physical, big, strong inside player.
4-3, VCU leading. Boy, that tournament tension, Dick, you can feel it for these two teams. Here's a drive and a miss inside by Vince Wilson.
Well, a lot's at stake. They know that they need this win to guarantee that NCAA berth. There's a foul in transition.
Vince Wilson picks up his second on a driving Frank Persley.
Persley gets behind him. There's the excellent pass by West right over the top of the defense. Now Wilson comes over and he bangs him. No doubt about the foul. You know, you talk about the tension. The reason right now there's a lot of tension. These teams will be on a bubble if they don't win this game in terms of an NCAA berth. And they want to apply the knockout punches. Hedlund comes on. He's from out of England, a big, strong inside player. They don't want to leave any doubt for any jury to decide.
Frank Persley, an excellent foul shooter, 80% on the campaign. It's the first one that ties the game just to put the 49ers on top, and it's good.
He had 20 in a row at one time and then hit 30 out of 32 during the course of the season. Got an excellent touch on a free throw line, Frank Persley. Man-to-man defense. He gets played off. They're going to let him shoot the jumper from the perimeter.
Loose ball. Cheeks recovers. Bacon in the game at guard, number 34.
Out of Louisville, Kentucky. Gives him another guard with quickness.
Nice tip by Persley, but Stinnie gets it back and fires.
He's having a tough time right now, Stinnie, but all good shooters, they'll just keep shooting.
Dinkins. In and out, back in.
Dinkins has had a tough time shooting the ball in the tournament. Had a little tragedy in his life. Had a lot of guts and fortitude to play Saturday when Jeff Mullins informed him that his granddad passed away.
Indeed. Dink has not shot the ball, under 40% of the two games. 7-4, UNCC.
Jeff Mullins has done such a super job rebuilding that program.
Hard to believe it was just 3 years ago that this ball club was struggling and single digits in the victory count. West baseballs it out to Dinkins. Byron had it knocked away. It is going to be out of bounds, touched by Cheeks, and the ball belongs to UNCC.
Well, he went out of bounds and came back inbounds. Right now, field goal percentages. VCU shooting 1-for-6, and UNCC 2-for-8.
But the 49ers have the lead. 7-4 with 15-12 left to play in the first half. A portion of over the 750 fans that made their way up from the Queen City in Charlotte, North Carolina to support the 49ers, and of course the homestanding D.C. Rams have a big crowd here at the Coliseum for the Sun Belt Conference Championship game.
They're really enthused about this game. You know, we were talking about Jeff Mullins and the job he's done as we look at the rebounding totals, and that's a shock because VCU has been an outstanding rebounding team all year long. But what about Mike Polio? He's done a great job everywhere he's been. He was at Kentucky Wesleyan, and he went to the Final Four in NCAA Division II three times. Unbelievable. Then they won the national championship last year under Wayne Chapman. Remember that name? King Rex Chapman's daddy.
Assisted Mike. Here's a takeaway by VCU. Chris Cheeks on the cut to Thompson. Now back up top to Cheeks. 7-4, 49ers on top. Cheeks in trouble. Here's Thompson. Knocked away by Persley. The 49ers are running. Dinkins. Now Bacon brings it out for VCU. And a half to play in the first half. Phil Stinnie, his first bucket of the game.
Just a matter of time. You can see he has the excellent offensive moves, good touch, catches the ball with his back to the basket, turns and shoots the little jumper, led the conference in scoring.
23.3, the numbers for Stinnie this year. A one-point lead for the 49ers.
Switch defensively, step out with the big guy, and he's called for a foul.
That will be the first on Martin Henlon. 6'10 junior from England. He came to this country as an exchange student. Ronnie Bellamy into the game now for UNCC. Going out is Frank Persley. 49ers on top, 7-6, 14:09 to play in the first half.
2-3 zone right now. The name Bellamy is very familiar to you. His brother was Walt Bellamy years ago. Excellent ball movement.
Barnes connects. Reggie Barnes coming off the best game of his career. So says his coach, Jeff Mullins. He had 12 yesterday against South Alabama. Hits his first shot tonight.
Well, they did a great job of reversing the ball against the zone. Stepped in a gap, and Barnes knew what to do with it when he caught it.
Stinnie. Bellamy the ball.
They have some good people off the bench, bringing in Bellamy and also Barnes.
Barnes, the hot hand. Misses this one. Rebound to Thompson.
Played at North Carolina State and transferred. Didn't get any playing time with Jimmy Valvano. Came here and has done an excellent job.
Stinnie couldn't get it to drop. Blocking the rebound. Dick, these two teams are up and down the floor.
Yeah, they're really moving up and down the floor. He loves this style of play. What a flashing move. That's a big time move by Mr. Dinkins, the most valuable player and player of the year in the Sun Belt Conference.
11-6, the 49ers on top.
He's an exciting player, Bob. You can see a great deal of excitement.
Here's a steal by Mike Washington.
Uh-oh.
Going all the way.
He looked like a fullback. He didn't show me that explosive slam jam bam. I was ready for a call. I wanted to jump out of my seat.
13-6, 49ers.
They're really working defensively, playing the passing lanes. You watch inside, Plunkey really working hard defensively on Stinnie.
Cheeks short, and another 49er rebound to Bellamy.
They want to push it up the court. 2-on-1. Give it up.
Dinkins scores.
That's the way you beat the 2-on-1 situation. Mike Polio doesn't like what he sees.
And one of those four precious timeouts he is forced to use. 12-17 remaining in the half with a score of the 49ers 15 and VCU 6. We'd like to remind you that the announcers for this game have been contracted for and approved by the Sun Belt Conference. Any use, rebroadcast, or other transmission of this game without the written consent of the Sun Belt Conference and Creator Sports Marketing is prohibited. Bob Rathbun and Dick Vitale back at the Richmond Coliseum. welcomes from all over here in the city of Richmond tonight.
Well, I had a great time, had an opportunity to speak to a bunch of youngsters tonight before the game, and just had a tremendous time. Beautiful people here in Richmond.
12:17 left. The folks here at the Coliseum, unless they're wearing the green and white of the 49ers, they don't like that scoreboard right now. 15-6, Charlotte.
Well, psychologically, it's really important to Jeff Mullins' team to get the lead after being beaten by this team twice during the course of the season. They have to find a way to believe that they can win, and this is the way you can believe, by getting this early lead.
Here's a lob inside to Petway, and he is fouled by Cedric Ball. Dick, there are a lot of ways to react to tournament pressure. The 49ers, and I think Jeff would tell you, they didn't play too well the first 2 days here. Lucky to beat Jacksonville, and a four-point game yesterday with South Alabama. But today, they look like they got all the pressure off of them, and they're playing free and easy.
Well, you know, in the first two basketball games, they were like the heavy favorite. Over here, they're like the underdog, playing here in Richmond, losing twice to them during the course of the year. The burden's always on that team that is the favorite, and I think that puts a little bit more pressure on VCU. Posted inside. Excellent post move down in the box by Petway.
Thompson, a long jump shot, but he connects. Pressure by VCU. This has been a great weapon for the Rams all season.
Thompson was highly acclaimed coming out of high school, recruited by Jimmy Valvano, left North Carolina State. Most kids leave because they don't get PT. They want to play.
Frank Persley's three-pointer. Tip up and off by Bellamy. Thompson clearing. Jakes, offensive foul, runs over Jeff West.
Well, he's out of control right there. He's got to give the ball up. He's trying to force the action. He's a good driving player, but he's trying to create opportunities that aren't there. Here he is spinning, whirling. There's the contact. Good call by Rutledge. That official that made that call, Don Rutledge, you ready for this? He worked the finals in 85 and 86 in the NCAAs. Last year in 87, he worked the semifinals. One of the better officials in the nation.
Whistle and a foul. And the man down is Frank Persley.
They can't afford to lose this guy. He's been their defensive stopper, physical player inside. They dump the ball inside. Here's the contact.
The foul charge to Mike Brown of VCU, and Persley is down.
He's an excellent free throw shooter. We talked about it earlier. Better than 80%. Had a streak this year of 20 in a row. Made 30 out of 32. As you look at Mike Polio, you talk about a fanatic on a sideline and a wild guy on that sideline. He makes Gary Williams and Bobby Knight look very calm. Take a look right here. We're going to see the contact. Boom. Looks like he got hit right in the right side of his face.
Yep.
Professor Jeff Mullins. I was teasing him. I said, you know, Bob, he was, I thought, undefeated when he was an announcer. I never thought he had the guts to want to become a sideline tactician.
You know, it's interesting, Dick, you talk about Jeff and Mike Polio, the different ways available for success. Here's Mike Washington coming in for Persley. Mullins had not been a coach. No coaching experience. He comes in, does a fantastic job. But Polio grinds it out. He starts as a junior high school coach.
Well, you know, Jeff Mullins had such a background. He played under so many positive people that have helped him. He developed a lot of their philosophies. You talk about under Vic Bubish, you talk about his high school days and then to the NBA, and he's transferred that on the collegiate level.
Whistle, foul on VCU.
Oh, that was really a lucky call because he was in big trouble right there in a traffic situation. This guy is just getting started. I'll guarantee you Mike Polio will put a show on that sideline.
Foul on Derek McGee. 15-8, UNCC leading. 11-minute mark of the first half. Dinkins. Yes.
Well, that was good execution. They swing the ball. Whenever you swing the ball and you get some good ball movement, you're going to create a good shot. And that time it was a shot under control. That's 8 points already for Mr. Dinkins. That kept Stinnie under control.
Bill has scored but two in this game. Bruce Petway puts it in.
Petway steps out off the screen. Good reversal to him. He shoots the open jumper.
Block, he throws it away against the pressure.
Good defensive pressure by VCU. Forces the turnover. They play a different style than, well, as we look at Jeff Mullins right here, the former All-American superstar on a scholastic collegiate level. different style VCU than it did under J.D. Barnett, who's now at Tulsa.
And Stinnie was recruited by J.D. He feeds it into Cheeks. Back out to McGee. Here's Thompson. And John Thompson puts in another big basket. That pulls VCU within five.
Nice little jump hook. No relation to John Thompson, the coach at Georgetown, whose son plays on a high school level. He has another son playing, one at Flint Hill, and then he has one son playing for Princeton, John Thompson.
West inside to Washington. That pivot foot nailed to the floor. Rebound, Plonky. Put it in.
He's a good inside player. Plonky, they call him, Jeff Mullins calls him the vanilla man. He's a key player to this team. They have to contain him, and he's got to score inside to give him some balance offensively from the perimeter to the interior.
A 7-point lead for the 49ers with 9:15 to play in the first half.
Jeff Mullins, I said, calls him the plain vanilla man. Nothing spectacular, very simple.
And as fundamentally sound a player as you'll find in college basketball.
We're talking about Plunkey, number 45. He's playing Stinnie right now. Oh, nice pass by Stinnie.
Thompson, tipped by Petway.
Petway's very active. He shows us the jump shot from the outside. Now he gets to the inside. Here's a look at the trap coming. That's the pass you want, the diagonal, the reversal pass away from the trapping defense. And they rotate into a man-to-man. Where's Shane to be?
Dinkins going one-on-one.
He's a good isolation man. He's the iso man, a one-on-one play. They get him for an offensive foul, though.
Count the basket.
Look at Dave Dinkins. Little shake and bake. There he is. In the rotation. Take a look at it right here. They got a hand on him. But he leans in. See, he's up in the air. The defensive player, that's the principle of verticality. He's entitled to that position. Good call by the official.
Any truth of the rumor that you helped Dr. Stites with that principle of verticality?
I can't spell it. Dinkins limping a little bit. He's had some problems with a hyperextended knee, a groin problem.
He's had those injuries since November, and he's aggravated that knee injury during the campaign.
What a change of direction. He looks okay to me right here.
Here's West. He, too, is playing with a bad wheel.
He's a better shooter from a stationary position than he is as a driver, West.
Frank Persley back into the 49er lineup after going out, shaking up a moment ago. Cheeks lob to Stinnie. Tough shot. Puts it in.
Stinnie is a good shooter. He'll get his points before tonight's over. You can just see he's a scorer. He has the mentality of a scorer.
21-16, UNCC. Dinkins on the baseline, rejected out of bounds by Stinnie.
Stinnie says, no, Mr. Dinkins. Oh, he loved that one. They had him all plumped up in practice today because it was reminding him that he didn't get the MVP. Here he comes over. He says, no, Dinkins, they gave me the MVP, but I'm the best.
7:49 remaining. Sun Belt Conference Championship from Richmond, Virginia. And in the early going, it's UNCC leading VCU 21-16. We'll be right back. Promotional consideration is provided by the Regency Inn, Richmond, Virginia. .749 left here in the first half, Dick.
That's a surprise right there when you look at the rebounding totals. VCU all year long has out-rebounded the opposition 39-30. And tonight you see UNCC with the rebounding edge. And there's the field goal percentage right now. VCU shooting 7-for-19. They're really in good shape. When you think about it, being down right now as they are, they're being out-rebounded and being out-shot from the field, and yet they're hanging right in there.
UNCC with the basketball as play resumes and Frank Persley puts it in. Lob out front, tipped away by McGee, and a foul on Derek McGee. Second foul on the Elizabeth, New Jersey junior.
With the ball thrown in bounds, and McGee comes over, makes contact on Plotkey. Elizabeth, New Jersey, they produced a fair player years ago by the name of John Shoemate, now an assistant in Notre Dame, played for Thomas Jefferson and was an All-American on a collegiate level.
Cedric Ball back into the 49er lineup.
He's a key player. We talked about his emotion. If he can get a couple of big baskets, he'll provide a tremendous lift for this team.
The the 49ers move into the bonus. Plonke, a 1-1. Third point for Dan Plonke. I think you were talking about Cedric Ball. It was his free throws with a second to go that enabled UNCC to beat Jacksonville in the opening round.
And he's really worked on improving on that free throw line. Started off the year very poorly, but worked with Jeff Mullins. Mullins was a great shooter. He's an excellent teacher.
22-16. UNCC. Plonke controlling.
Stinnie is a jump shooter. I'd look for him to drive a little more. He wants to score everything off the jump shot as opposed to driving to the basket. Good motion offensively. Dinkins trying to come off the screen, curling to the outside.
And Lionel Bacon across the arms picks up the foul. The one luxury, Dick, that VCU has playing this tough defense is particularly at the point guard position. Mike Folio has 15 fouls at his disposal between Bacon, Cheeks, Wilson, Brown, etc.
Well, we talked about earlier that depth at the guard slot. They're able to rotate a lot of people there. That's been a positive plus for them all season long.
Missing the front end of the 1-1 is Dinkins. And the Rams have the basketball.
You know, both clubs have 21 wins, but 21 wins doesn't guarantee a tournament berth any longer with the criteria of utilizing the computer for home court, wins, away wins, strength of schedule, strength of conference, a lot of factors involved. Quickest way to get it is get a win here.
Dinkins missing the three-pointer, the rebound to Martin Hedlund, and the foul charge to Cedric Ball. Second foul on Cedric.
Here comes Petway back on the floor. He had two big baskets, one through the perimeter, one down on the inside. What a player he was at Duke. I used to love watching him play. They had some great teams there under the Vic Bubas era.
And, of course, Jeff played with the world champs in the NBA.
1975, they had a fair player by the name of Rick Barry on that team.
Here's Lionel Bacon to Cheeks. They were anticipating the shot. Well, Bacon can't save it, and it's out of bounds.
Well, he can't pick up the ball once he let it go. Boy, hanging up in the air. A lot of turnovers right now. VCU with 7. UNCC with 4. That's big, big numbers as well. Right now, they got to try to get Plonke established inside and get him to score a little more. He's got to slide inside 45. There's a screen. They should have dumped it to him. They missed him.
Hursley forcing and missing. Ball taps it in. Plonke throws it off the leg of Pedway, and it belongs to UNCC.
Watching Plonke today, he has a lot of good moves inside. We'll watch the hustle right now of Dan Plonke. Actually, it was Cedric Ball first. Now Plonke. He throws the ball off the leg of Pedway.
Boy, that is some heads-up basketball right there by Mr. Plonke.
They got a dump of the ball inside. He's getting close position, but they're missing. Now they rotate into a zone. Come out of the man-to-man, zone 2-3. The wing should be open right there. Reverse it to the wing, and you got an open jump shot.
Plonke had it knocked away. Cheeks tips it over to Dinkins. So the 49ers still have it. 5:50 left in the first half, but a 22-16 lead for the 49ers.
Byron Dinkins doesn't like to see the zone. He'd rather see the man-to-man so he can drive and slash for the goal.
Dinkins gets around.
Oh,
Cheeks
great
inside the ball. Missed the shot, but he got fouled and will shoot 2.
Very unselfish play right there by Byron Dinkins. He had the opportunity to shoot the J, but he dumped it down inside the open teammate. There he is now, hanging in the air. He spots ball inside. Gets it ball with the head fake. Now goes to the line.
The personal was charged to Phil Stinnie. Jeff West is back in. Reggie Barnes going out for the 49ers. Martin Hedlund is in for VCU, and Bruce Pedway goes out of the game.
Ball shot 59% for the year from the free throw line, and he started off very poorly, kept getting better and better as the year progressed.
In the first 11 games, Dick, 33%, and that's 75% the last 17.
And he made the two biggest of his career against Jacksonville, as you said a little bit earlier, with 1 second left. They're down 1 point. A little bit of an upset. Stood on that line. So this is for you, Coach Mullins. Nothing but nylon twice.
24-16, UNCC on top. Dick, it's an interesting note. The host school has been in the finals of this tournament 7 straight years, but the host school has lost the last 3 in a row.
The only one to win it at home was UAB, Gene Barker. Where's Gene? He's usually here.
A quick exit for the Blazers this season. A real disappointment.
Well, they played without their star, Michael Charles, an outstanding player in the tournament. They had the big win over Brigham Young, but it was really an up-and-down year. Put Michigan to the wire. It's a good inside player. Good move along the base.
Stinnie, no basket. The foul before the shot on Frank Forsman.
See, that's what he's got to utilize. When you're not shooting the jump shot, here's Phil Stinnie. They entered inside. There's the head fake, and now he's going to drive. I talked about it a little bit earlier, how he's going to add a little bit more to his game and add the driving angle rather than just shooting the jump shot.
Chris Cheeks will get it in. Wilson is open. Washington the rebound.
Washington, big wide body, really attacked the glass.
He had 7 rebounds yesterday in the victory over South Alabama.
This kid's got so many moves with the ball number 4.
Dick Charlotte's got a chance to put some distance between themselves and UNC and the VCU right here. Hursley hitting. That's a 2-point field goal.
Well, nice screen action, a down screen. They ran a nice screen as the biggest lead of the night right now. They're up 10, but it was an excellent move, reversing the ball and running the down screen for Hursley to get open. They're really working hard on Stinnie. I'll tell you, they are really rotating different bodies on him.
Wilson, another 3-point attempt, puts this one in.
Gets it back in the game with a trifecta. Wilson lets it fly.
Wilson has shot the ball well here. 10 for 14 coming into the 2 tournament games.
Posey's playing Mr. Stinnie now. We'll go down to the other end. Oh, could be a charge. Yes, sir. Good call. That's a 2nd foul on Dinkins. Both have been charging fouls.
So the turnover gives VCU the ball.
A lot of people think if you're moving that it's a foul on the defensive player. If the defensive player is able to establish position initially by having both feet on the ground, he's entitled to move, and if you make contact, the foul's on the offensive player.
Good call by Jake Bell. 4:05 left in the half. 26-19, and the ball touched by Stinnie last. It's out of bounds to UNCC, so the 49ers get it right back.
Stinnie getting a little frustrated right now. He's just got to get himself some easy baskets by trying to drive a little more and getting out of transition.
Dick, I know that line that you use so often. You've got to let the game come to you when they're putting the defensive pressure on you. Here's Plotke inside.
That's the guy they have to go to inside. Excellent screen and roll. What good execution they're getting, Bob, and you're right about that point. He's right now getting a little frustrated rather than just taking the shots as they come.
Cheeks. Bruce Pedway. No, it's Thompson inside. Scoring.
Bill Thompson with an offensive rebound. He said, Jimmy Valvano, take a look at me. I could have helped your Wolf Pack. Hey, they're playing well. They got a chance to do something special in the tournament this year. I like that North Carolina State team.
Washington kicks it out to Persley. Rebound to Henlon. West nearly flipped it away. Here's Wilson controlling. And a foul on Jeff West.
Jeff West reaching in from behind. 2nd foul on West.
I think only Jeff knows how much that right knee is hurting. It ballooned on him here last Saturday night in the final regular season game against the Rams, and it's really been hurting him.
He's had a lot of injuries in his career. I talked about it earlier. He had a, I guess he fractured a bone in his foot last year prior to the start of the season. He missed about 10 games and then averaged 10 points a game after that.
Ronnie Bellamy back in for the 49ers. You know, Washington goes out.
I passed it over before, but you remember Walt Bellamy. Played so many years
Bells.
In the NBA. Bells. That's his brother. That's his young brother. I'm not kidding either. I'm serious.
Reggie Barnes is in the game. All you Detroit guys stick together.
His dad is 82 years old, Mr. Bellamy.
Wow. Here's Wilson.
Bless him.
Vince has scored 4. He had a big shot earlier this year, a 3-pointer at the buzzer, beat UAB in Birmingham. In and out, stays out. Rebound tip, West controls.
West a good shooter. If they can get him off the screen, he's capable of driving that jump shot down. Defense. They're getting some good ball movement, lots of screens inside. Monkey really knows how to hold position inside. There's a ceiling off. He wants to reverse the ball and dump it in.
Shot outside. Good by Bellamy.
Bellamy comes off the bench. He drills the jumper.
His brother Walt would be very proud.
30-22 the score. UNCC has been in control of this first half. Stinnie, short again. Rebound, Cheeks.
Cheeks and Wilson doing a good job keeping him in the game.
A 6-point lead for the 49ers.
Both teams are really playing well defensively. Offensively struggling a little bit in terms of their rhythm. Lefty does a great job. Watch how he'll slide inside of a 45, lay the screen, and then he'll slide. They keep missing him.
Bellamy again.
Bellamy wide open. Nothing but nylon. A little FBN.
32-24. The 49ers keeping VCU at arm's length at the two-minute mark.
Shows he has an excellent touch. You know, Bellamy struggled in the middle of the year, but then finally got some PT against VCU, and now he's back contributing again.
1:48 to play here in the first half. 32-26 UNCC. A minute 48 left in the first half of the Sun Belt Championship game. UNCC leading VCU 32-26. Byron Dinkins has scored 10 to lead all scorers in the game. The winner of this, of course, getting that automatic bid from the Sun Belt Conference to the NCAA. Right now, we're going to let you listen to the voice of the VCU Rams. On the left of your screen, Terry Sisiski, as he describes the action of this championship game.
4 for Fenway, 2 for Hedlund, and 4 for Vince Wilson. So it is going to be Jeff West to inbound it for Charlotte and full court pressure. West gets an inbound to Plunkey, double team to the backcourt, gets it off to Barnes, Barnes across the timeline, Barnes on the wing left, now comes outside with a dribble. 32-26, right sideline to West, covered up by Lionel Bacon, whistle away from the ball. They say Hedlund was holding underneath. Martin second, it'll be 1-1 for Dan Plunkey, who at the line tonight is 1-2. 32-26, UNC Charlotte leading, a minute 36, time remaining, first half. Here comes Bruce Fenway in the game for the Rams, taking a seat at Hedlund.
So that's how the Richmond radio audience is hearing tonight's championship game. The voice of the Rams, Terry Sisiski. Meanwhile, Dan Plunkey is at the line.
You know, in their two meetings, if you talk to some people as he comes up short right there, about the meetings, VCU feels they dominated. But you talk to the people at Charlotte, they said, well, we went on a road trip. We won 3 games in 3 different cities, 6 nights. Came home as we watched the action inside. Came home on a Sunday, didn't practice, played on Monday, and were physically fatigued and were beaten severely. And then they talk about the time they were also blown out, even though a lot of people say that the meeting over at Charlotte was a lot closer than the 8-point margin at the end.
Yeah, Jeff was talking on his TV show last night back to Charlotte, Dick, that, hey, the 49ers haven't shown VCU the real UNCC team yet.
Well, last year he swept them 3 times. And today, early before the teams came out on the floor, they were chanting to VCU fans, sweep, sweep, sweep.
3 fouls on Jeff West as Stinnie puts it home. That's his 5th point. 32-27 is the score.
I got a feeling Stinney's going to break loose in the second half. I really do. He's playing for that MVP award here, along with Mr. Dinkins. Many people, as we said earlier, felt that he should have been the player of the year, led the conference in scoring. But the coaches felt otherwise. They thought that Dinkins did so much more for UNCC. Plus, they won the league, and I always believe you go with the victory.
Pressure by the Rams. Plunkey brings it up.
They're well coached. They really are. They really execute well offensively. Play some good screens and some excellent curl moves. They'll even post the little guy inside, Dinkins.
Shot clock at 20, game clock at a minute.
Patience on offense.
Bellamy lets it fire and he hits it again.
He's hit 3 in a row.
Ronnie Bellamy off the bench with 6 for the 49ers. 34-28.
Big possession right here.
Cheeks fires 3. And tipped out by both Pedway and Bellamy. A hell ball possession, VCU.
Big possession right there, because when you look at that possession, you're down 6. If you don't score and they go up 8 on you, that's a big difference in going in halftime down 4. So they have to get a score right here, the Rams.
The shot clock is off now with 30 seconds left in the hand.
See, they're putting the big guy now.
Offensive foul, Phil Stinnie.
Yeah, he leaned in. Good defensive position. He knew it as he walked up the floor. Number two on Stinnie. Sometimes when you're struggling offensively like he is, then we look at Plonkey, beats him with position, maybe a little acting too. But you know, when you're struggling like that, sometimes it's best to take him out of the game for a minute or two.
Dinkins to the bucket.
What a quick move.
Tip by Plonkey. Bacon had it. Now it's Petway and VCU with it. 17, 16 seconds left.
They go to Stinnie. They're going to really try to lock Stinnie up inside if they're going to look for him.
It's going to be Wilson. A little alley opens, and he puts it in.
Oh, good one-on-one move. Excellent spin move. He whirls. Good isolation right there by Wilson. Wilson has done a fine job off the bench.
We're at the half, and the 49ers of Jeff Mullins have a four-point halftime lead, 34-30. Let's go to Bob Lee. An interesting first half lead with the Sun Belt Tournament Championship on the line. We'll continue in just a moment. We're at the half at the Richmond Coliseum in Richmond, Virginia, the Sun Belt Conference Championship game. The UNCC 49ers are leading here at the half by the score of 34-30. When leading at halftime this year, the 49ers have won 14 and lost only two, and they like to continue that winning streak here tonight. Back with more after this.
You probably do this game without their phone.
Yeah? Really?
How's it going?
Good.
Yeah, up and down.
I know, I mean, a game itself.
Oh, yeah. We're at the half here at the Richmond Coliseum with the halftime score, UNCC 34 and VCU 30. At stake, of course, the Sun Belt Conference Championship and a bid into the NCAAs. Dick Vitale, when you take a look at that first half of basketball coming into the game, the big difference why VCU won both regular season matchups is the fact that they dominated the backboards. Early on, UNCC controlled the backboards, and conversely, they had the lead in the half here.
Well, they've dominated the backboards all year long. Their rebounding margin's better than nine, and that's one of the better rebounding margins in the nation when you're talking VCU. But UNCC really came out very enthused, and they wanted to establish the tempo immediately that they were going to control the backboards and certainly neutralize them. And they really did an excellent job. I thought they did a fine job defensively on Stinnie, who's a fine offensive player. They really negated him in that first half. I think right now, Mike Polio's got to feel pretty good to be only down four and really not playing as capable as they're capable of playing.
No question. Byron Dinkins has shaken off the ill effects of two poor tournament games. He's come back strong tonight with 10 first half points.
Well, he's a slashing player. I really like watching him. He's got a lot of shake and bake in him, and he's got good quickness, and he knows what to do with the basketball. He's also a very unselfish player. He makes a couple of great passes inside. I like the kid Blonkey. He knows how to play. He really knows how to hold off the defense, how to seal inside to get free for the ball. Both these teams are well coached.
Oh, that they are. Testimony to both Jeff Mullins and Mike Polio. I agree with you, though, Dick. VCU playing on its home floor. You look for the edges in this game, and the fact that they've got over 7,000-8,000 cheering for them tonight has to help down the stretch.
Well, also the fact that they know that they've beaten this team twice psychologically has got to be a positive plus, too, as they're sitting inside. I thought practice was interesting today watching Mike Polio. He was so fiery, so intense. On the other side, watching Jeff Mullins, he's laid back like the professor, just an artist at work, and it's just contrast. You made a good point earlier. You show two contrasting personalities, yet they can be successful in their own way. I think the key in that is you have to be yourself.
no question. And certainly this UNCC program has made tremendous strides in just 3 years under Jeff Mullins, not only the head basketball coach, but also the athletic director at UNCC. And he's done it, I think, Dick, the right way. He's gone after quality people. He's got them into the program. He's building. They're going to be good next year as well, because he's got a lot of recruits, as we have the stats are coming our way. But he's had a very good recruiting year. He's got 2 6-11s coming into the program next season. So he's established a foundation to return UNCC to the glory days. And he was asked earlier, he said, you know, what about moving on, getting another job in coaching? He says, no, I really want to build UNCC and return them to the glory days of the Final Four. And if he could pull that off, that would be quite a success story.
Well, he likes the city of Charlotte. It's a beautiful city, and he really feels very comfortable there. He's got a tremendous background in the state of North Carolina with his success at Duke, certainly as a player, and made a lot of contacts. And he's a class act. There's no doubt. I mean, he is one of the class people. I questioned his intelligence when he took the job. I said, you're doing TV, Jeff. You're undefeated. Why do you want the world of coaching? He said, I just want to try it. I know this. See what happened to my head coaching? I lost all of my hair getting to that wacky world.
VCU is certainly to be complimented off the weekend that they've put together here for the Sun Belt Conference Tournament. The city of Richmond and Virginia Commonwealth University has done a whale of a job hosting the Sun Belt.
Well, really a lot of classy people. I had the opportunity tonight to address a large number of youngsters prior to game time, and I met a lot of people from Richmond, and they're really excited. They're anticipating. They really want that big entry into the magical party. And what a special time of the year this is. March Madness. I know I get enthused and excited about basketball. I'm a basketball junkie. I was teasing some people yesterday. I said, heck, you can have the World Series, the Super Bowl. Give me the NCAA tournament. It's the greatest moment. That Final Four is so special.
Dick, we've got just a few seconds, but if, as your player, is that thought going through your mind at all times when you play in a tournament like this?
I think right now, to these kids, they know what's at stake. They've watched TV, and they want to be part of that. It's such an exciting moment.
We're at the half in the Sun Belt Conference Championship game here at the Richmond Coliseum with UNCC leading VCU by 4. We'll come back right after this. Welcome back. We're at the half here at the Richmond Coliseum. 34-30, UNCC is on top in the Sun Belt Championship game, and a bid to the NCAA is on the line. Well, thank you very much, Bob Lee, at the half here at the Coliseum in Richmond, Virginia. 34-30 is our halftime score. UNCC has controlled this first half of basketball, Dick. They did it early on by gaining an advantage on the backboards.
Well, they caught me with a turnover, throwing a wire over my shoulder, but hey, they really did. They did a great job rebounding. But the key stat, I thought, was stopping Stinnie. Stinnie, the outstanding scorer, was held to 2-for-10, and it was because of excellent defense. I think he's going to break loose. I don't think you're going to hold down a scorer of his quality. Dinkins was outstanding in the first half.
That he was, and here is a shot of 2 of his 10.
Well, a little off balance, slashing drive to the goal. He's an excellent slashing player, the player of the year in the conference. Watch Petway working out inside. He's got good inside position. Has the tip, gets the deuce. Very active, number 52, Petway.
One of the quiet men who gets the job done for the 49ers.
Oh, what a great job sealing off the defense by Plotke. Gets good post position. Now we watch the drive right here by Cheeks. Good hang time. Strong baseline drive by the guard. Now we're going to watch the steal by Washington. No, he's not ultra quick. He's not going to play up in the sky. But, oh, that deuce counts the same as a slam jam bammer, baby. That is the same as taking it and going boom.
You wanted him to jam it, though.
I was ready to roll. I had all my adjectives. He let me down.
Well, with VCU trailing just by 4 points, Dick, here at the half, they are playing on their home court, and that might be a big advantage coming down the stretch. We'll talk more about that when we continue from the Richmond Coliseum. We're at the half of the Sun Belt title game. We were talking earlier with Dick Vitale about the comparisons between Dinkins and Stinnie. Their first half numbers, Byron Dinkins scored 10 points on 5 of 11 floor shooting. Phil Stinnie only 6. Stinnie took 10 first half shots and made but 2. He missed a three-pointer, hit 2 at the line, and scored 6. So the big key for VCU, as Dick pointed out, is getting Phil Stinnie active in that offense. He was the Sun Belt's leading scorer at 23.3 points per game in the regular season. 34-30, UNCC leading VCU here at halftime in the Sun Belt Conference championship game. No upset so far in this tournament. All the seeds have advanced. Number one, UNCC against number two, VCU. And Dick, here's a look at the halftime numbers.
Well, they picked up the numbers a little bit from the early start. VCU shooting 40%, UNCC 44%. So very close from that area. Three-point field goals, UNCC 2-for-4, VCU only 1-for-6. Not really a major factor. Free throws, 5-for-6 and 5-for-8. So very close in that situation. Rebound and totals. This, to me, is the key. VCU being, well, in a situation where they're plus one right now, rebounded, but all year long they have dominated the glass. Earlier meeting, they had 24 offensive rebounds in one game. So right here, UNCC's done a good job to negate that. Turnovers, UNCC with 10, VCU with 6.
And those turnovers for VCU coming out of the front court, Thompson and Stinnie.
Well, a bench scoring, UNCC goes a little deeper in the bench. It's 10 points off their bench. Bellamy was the key with that. He's a big jumpers off the bench.
There's the individual scoring for VCU. Pretty good balance, I'd say, but four players with 6 apiece and no one with over 2 fouls. For Jeff Mullins and the UNCC 49ers, Byron Dinkins, of course, atop the heap with 10. But Bellamy, as you mentioned, Dick, a big positive force for the 49ers off the bench with 6.
Yeah, he hit 3 big jump shots.
Well, he's 20 minutes. Court advantage, its factor and presence in the second half.
Well, it's got to be a factor. Anytime you play in an environment that you're familiar with, it's certainly got to be positive. However, as you indicated, in the last 7 times the home team has been in the final, only one has been a winner. Back in, I guess, 84 was UAB.
Here's Jeff West as the 49ers start playing the second half. Ball alone, lays it in.
Good entry inside, an emotional player. I believe that's his first basket. That could be a great lift for him psychologically.
36-30, UNCC, a runner by Wilson. Stinnie inside.
Yeah, see, that's what you have to do if you're a scorer. Get some garbage. Don't rely just on your jump shot.
On the quick break, Dinkins, up and in.
Oh, great job attacking the pressure. Rather than backing it out, they attack it. Also, Illinois yesterday, for example, against Iowa, they went out to feigned Iowa press and finalized the score, and that's what they did right here, the 49ers.
Cheek slides it across to Petwood.
Good pass by Cheeks inside, good interior play. And they're coming out pressing all over the place, trying to pick up the tempo of the game.
West fires it up to Plonky.
That pass works all the time, the diagonal pass. Good bounce pass.
Foul, Phil Stinnie, number 3.
Plonky, what a nice pass. Good bounce pass. That's a big foul on Stinnie. That's number 3. Look at Plonky. Nothing fancy. As I said earlier, as Coach Jeff Mullins says, that's the plain vanilla man, Mr. Plotke. Very simple. Look at Stinnie coming over the top. Hey, what a decision now for Mike Polio. Do you take Stinnie out and rest him a while? I say keep him on the floor with 3.
And he is on the floor. Cedric Ball, 3-for-3 at the line in this game. And 5 points as the 49ers look to take a 6-point lead. And they do.
He looks pretty good at that free throw line. Hard to believe earlier this year he's shooting 30-some percent.
And a steal by Jeff West over to Dinkins.
Good play by Dinkins to back it out.
Oh, the 49ers have been sharp here to start the second half. And it is Persley connecting.
They are dominating the action here in the first couple minutes. Sometimes as a coach, you wait for that TV timeout, and that could be a little bit too late.
Mike has already used 1 timeout. He has 3 remaining. Jeff Mullins has all 4 of his. Stinnie jams it.
What a great pass. They lost sight of Stinnie. Didn't see him. Cheeks with the great entry inside. See, they swing it side to side. They are well drilled against the pressure.
Persley from the corner. Yes!
Frank Persley lighting it up. Hey, the tempo has picked up, the rhythm. This is excellent basketball right now. There's been some great basketball over the years in the Sun Belt Conference. When you think of those teams in Western Kentucky, and certainly Gene Bartow, he's had fantastic success. One of the great architects in all of college basketball.
Tip ball, Bacon secures it. Outside, Chris Cheeks connects, and a foul on Dan Plotke of UNCC.
Good ball reversal of Cheeks. The basket counts.
The first foul of this championship game on Dan Plotke.
Now we watch him reverse the ball. He steps right up into the gap. shoots the jumper cheeks. There's the foul away from the action. Now they'll get possession of the ball. This could be possibly a 5-point play if they can hit a trifecta. Man-to-man defense. Let's see how they play Stinnie inside. There's a screen for him. Bursley's playing him now, number 35, not blocking.
Cheeks powers up and in.
Hey, Cheeks is playing well. He really is. Made a great pass a moment ago. Did two jump shots with a full court trap.
West to mid floor and Dinkins.
44-40. They do a good job rotating back after the ball beats the front wave defensively. To look inside the Plotkey. Get great position to the baseline.
Bursley, a three-pointer. Now rebound to Petwood.
You know, there's a special art to make that pass to the post. To be a guy that can feed the post, you need special ability. Not many guys can make that pass.
Jake,
shoot it. He wants to shoot it. He feels it.
Well, it looked like the 49ers were able to take control, but now VCU has a chance to cut it down, and they do. It's a two-point game as Stinnie connects. Cedric Ball. And
oh, that's deliberate. That's deliberate.
Foul.
Got to call the intentional right there. And Rutledge will call it. That's why he's one of the premier officials in basketball. Look at Mike Polio. We watch the pass over the top of the defense. Looks like they have a steal, but no. Here comes the grab. And that, remember, two shots plus the ball.
And they've counted the basket.
Look at
and
Polio.
Mike Polio, Polio can't believe it.
So now if the basket counts, you get the score, and I believe you get possession of the ball.
So one, two free throws for Cedric Ball, and the ball out of bounds at the point of the foul, which will be underneath the goal. Here's another look, Dick.
Oh, he definitely grabs him. I don't think there's any doubt about it. Rutledge right there with the ball. Look at him. Plus those arms. I say count that basket. I think that's an excellent call. John Thompson made the play and grabbing them.
So the lane will be cleared because of the intentional foul, and Cedric shoots two shots.
So we got a possible 7-point play. He scores, makes two here, get the ball out of bounds and hit a three. Hey, I wasn't a genius at all, but I could add 3-2-2. That's what a master's degree did for me. I should be a great inspiration to every youngster. I can get a master's, anybody can.
Ball goes 1-for-2, his ninth point. Now the 49ers have it underneath their own basket. 47-42 with 16:35 remaining in the game.
I can feel the excitement right here because you know what's at stake, that gold trophy. Anytime you play for a championship, there's special flavor. 2-3 zone right now. We'll have that over in the Big East at Madison Square Garden down in Greensboro.
Bonkey through his hands. VCU
give
running.
Give a bounce pass.
Cheeks to the bucket. Tip by Stinnie is good.
Oh, I don't know about maybe playing with that up on a cylinder. Stinnie is pumped up. I told you he was going to break loose, Bob.
And keep in mind, Dick, he's playing with those three personal.
He already has, I believe, 8 points in this half.
14 for the game. Dickens pressure. Here's Pursley. Pursley going up, and that is going to be an offensive foul on Pursley.
Pursley trying to force the action. He goes off the driving lane. Stinnie is all pumped up. Stinnie is all pumped up.
Dick, we're going to take a look at that last VCU basket. Let's see if Stinnie touched it in the cylinder.
Here's the drive by Cheeks. Now you watch Stinnie. Here he comes over with the offensive tip. Is it up there? No, it looks like it's off. I don't know. Very close from the angle I'm looking at. Very close.
A timeout here. 15:59 left in the championship game of the Sun Belt. Jeff Mullins and the 49ers lead it right now by three, but VCU's on a roll. Welcome back to the Richmond Coliseum, second half of the Sun Belt title game. UNCC leading it by three. Here's that last drive by Pursley.
Watch how they close the line. Here it is, right up. Freeze it. C35, Stinnie come over. He closes off the driving angle. Now right here, by taking away that driving angle, the offensive player takes the charge right there. I say offensive player, Stinnie, a fine offensive player, demonstrated some good defense right there.
15:59 remaining in the championship game, and we've been joined here tableside by the commissioner of the Sun Belt Conference, Vic Bubas. And Vic, a great championship game so far.
Well, we've had a lot of close ones, and this is a good one to have for the championship.
Well, I tell you, this has to be a little bit special for you, watching the guy on the sideline that you coached over at Duke in those great years. Certainly one of my favorite coaches, I have to say this, Bob. He retired too early. What feelings do you get watching Jeff Mullins, who played on your great Duke teams?
Well, first of all, I have to be impartial. But secondly, we're all very proud of Jeff. He's done a marvelous job, and he's a fine young man.
Vic, I want to ask you about the NCAA. Here's Petway firing, and VCU misses, and the rebound to Dinkins. Your thoughts on these two teams should for the loser of this game?
Well, I think that both these teams are worthy of a good, long, hard look by the NCAA committee. They got a tough job, but I think either one of them would do well in the tournament, and I have no reason whatsoever to apologize for it.
Great play right there, Bob. Active inside move. You know, over the years, there have been some outstanding teams, Vic, in the Sun Belt Conference. Right now, you're looking at these two basketball teams, and as you said, you certainly don't have to apologize. What's your assessment using your coaching background of Stinnie and also Dinkins?
I think Stinnie is going to be an excellent pro. And the reason I say that is he can go outside and hit that shot. He's got great mobility, fine strength. He runs the floor well. What else do you want a guy his size to do?
Yeah, he can't shoot the ball. Even when he started off slowly here, you just knew it's a matter of time. I'll tell you a player I like, number 45, Plonky. And I remember Vic Bubas teaching big man moves when you were at Duke. And he demonstrates a lot of the moves that you taught when you were coaching.
Well, he's sort of a workhorse guy, a steady player, always gets a job done, nothing flashy. He does indeed have fine moves around the bucket. And I thought maybe he was using your moves.
No, fine. Hey, Vic, one other question. I know you have some real good ideas about some rules you'd like to change. I want you to share those with the people on and all over the nation.
Very quickly, I'm going to ask our coaches after the season to consider using the professional lane, the wider lane. I think that lane is too narrow for the game the way it is now. The officials can't call everything. They're leaning on each other. Too close. Secondly, we're going to ask our coaches to go to 35 seconds rather than 45. And after we go to 35, if we do, I will ask that the five-second count be taken off because they all call it a different way. I don't know if our coaches will agree or our conference or the rules committee, but that's our plan to ask right now.
Well, you were the first conference, I believe, that was innovative in creating the 45-second shot clock.
Yes, the Sun Belt did.
Well, that's right, and I think these things are good for college basketball, or I wouldn't ask our people to consider it.
Absolutely. Vic, thanks for coming by.
Thank you. You guys do a great job.
Thanks a lot, Coach.
Vic Bubas, the commissioner of the Sun Belt Conference, former chair of the NCAA Men's Basketball Committee. We've got 14:30 left to play in the ball game. 49-46 is the score, with UNCC leading. Plotke firing and hitting.
What a good job again. Spacing was excellent. They had good spacing against the zone, and then they read the gap and got the ball to Plonky into the gap. Man-to-man defense right here by UNCC.
Cheeks is fouled by Washington.
He's really playing hard, Cheeks. He is really trying to carry this team, but Stinney's done a solid job in the second half. There's a look at Mike Polio. What an intense competitor.
14 minutes and 3 seconds left. 51-46 is the score.
He served as an assistant coach here back in the early 70s. Then he was an assistant also at Old Dominion. He's got a fine staff, too. Eddie Webb on that sideline is the son of Paul Webb, who did a great job at Old Dominion for years.
Stinnie missing. Wilson up and off and a foul on UNCC. And in the front position, Ronnie Bellamy picks up his first foul.
There's the Bell's brother, Walter Bellamy. Played at Indiana, played for years in the NBA. Big center, that's his brother, young baby brother, Ronnie Bellamy.
Dick, VCU's made a couple of strong surges here in the second half, yet UNCC's been able to hold them off.
Well, they've answered the challenge. See, that's a sign of being a good basketball team. When a team makes a run at you, you can come up with a quality play.
Vince Wilson will be at the free throw line. He's from Sumter, South Carolina. He has scored 8 points tonight.
Well, he hit a big basket, I thought, at near the end of the half. that gave them a little bit of momentum, gave them a little, well, a little feeling going back in that locker room, because they were in trouble there for most of the first half. When they were down by 10, it looked like UNCC was in complete command.
Vince Wilson hits them both.
Now they're going to face score it on the inbounds of the ball.
You can take a look at that VCU pressure.
Yep, they get it over the top, go right. Keep the front away.
Dinkins.
Oh, he carried it. I thought they missed the carry right there.
51-48. 3-point lead for the 49ers.
Stamina was always a problem for Dinkins, but he built his body up. He was 135 pounds. Now he's about 165.
Inside Washington over Henley. Block in the offensive stick back.
Always in the right place. Makes the right play. Nothing spectacular. Solid, solid.
53-48. UNCC, you see the time remaining.
He's leaning all over Stinnie. He wants to post him inside, so Stinnie wants to show he can go inside and outside.
And another foul on Mike Washington.
That's a good move by Stinnie. He was playing on a perimeter in the first half and was ineffective, was 2-for-10. Now he goes inside and he demonstrates what Big Bubas was talking about, the ability to go inside and outside. Good hands, leans in. He's a kid that a lot of NBA scouts are really evaluating. Good potential for the NBA.
Frank Bursley returns. And Phil Stinnie to shoot two shots. Derek McGee is now coming in for VCU. And Chris Cheeks is going out of the game. Phil Stinnie on the threshold of establishing a new Sun Belt Conference tournament record here at the free throw line.
He breaks the record of Edmund Sherrard with that. Remember Sherrard? He played with Zalula. Knickerbockers, he's on his staff now as an assistant coach here with VCU.
69 points for Stinnie. The old record 68 by Sherrard in 1980.
Sherrard played for UB Brown with the Knicks and had really, really a lot of injuries in the struggle city.
Bill's got 16. This is a three-point basketball game.
They just hang in that dangerous position. And the crowd is getting up, trying to give them a big lift defensively. Here's the crowd involved.
Dinkins rolls it in.
I mean, is that a play? Is that a play? One-on-one, spinning, hanging, off balance, and he converts it. And they go wild in Charlotte.
Wilson pinned to the baseline, intercepted. Boy, that play was made by Plotkin.
Look at Dinkins pushing it up the court.
Dinkins spins to the lane and lays it up and off. Boy, just didn't get the roll.
He wanted Carl Shear to see him there. Coach, he's going to be the GM, or he is the GM of the Charlotte Hornets.
Intercepted by Persley. Back-to-back turnovers for VCU. The 49ers looking to increase their lead.
Good poise right there. I thought he was going to take a bad shot right there, Dinkins, but excellent poise.
Near steal, Dinkins firing three. Over the backboard and out of bounds to VCU.
He is not what you would call a good shooter. He is a scorer. He's a slasher. He's a driver. He's not what I would call a good balance, what I would call a pure shooter.
Lionel Bacon in for VCU. This is Cedric Ball coming into the game.
Well, we mentioned Charlotte. That's going to add a lot of enthusiasm in that city, having an NBA franchise, and I think that'll even help the collegiate level. It'll bring a basketball environment. Hey, hire a coach. They should hire Lefty Drizel. Why waste any time? Larry Brown doesn't want to go 20-62. There's no way his personality can hang that. The left-hander will have that town jumping with joy.
The left-hander. Boy, he used to stomp his foot at the old Charlotte Coliseum.
Well, I'm a little bit biased. I want to get him out of TV business because he's liable to take my job. So good Drizel in the coaching.
Stinnie, a long bomb. Too long. Cheeks blocked and a foul.
Cheeks is really making things happening here in the second half. Good drive by Cheeks along that baseline. He's got a quick first step.
Dan Plotkin picking up his second personal foul.
There's the jump shot by Stinnie. Doesn't look good on this one. Looked like a knuckleball. Here comes Cheeks. See, he beats Plotkin with the good inside speed. The ball by Jake Bell.
Cheeks has been a very consistent performer for VCU this year. game against the 49ers in Charlotte. Cheek scored 18. He had 14 points in the rematch here at the Coliseum.
You know, they came to the tournament really on the downside. They had lost three of the last four. Were beaten by Miami without Vito Horford. They got beat by Oklahoma State. So they really got revitalized here in this tournament and really got themselves rejuvenated and played well in the tournament.
11:35 left. Mike Polio's DC Rams within three of UNCC. 55-52 is the score with UNCC leading VCU. 11 minutes and 35 seconds, the time remaining.
Well, you know, college basketball really high here in this city. Richmond battling for an NCAA berth as well under Dick Tarrant, who I think is one of the solid tacticians in the nation, and VCU doing the same. And I think that's great for the city. It's bringing a lot of basketball enthusiasm to the city of Richmond.
Indeed, Richmond playing George Mason tonight in Hampton, Virginia for the Colonial Athletic Association title. So the UNCC 49ers will have it, and Reggie Barnes will get it in.
There's that pressure, face guarding. They line up in a 1-4 line. Four guys across the line, and they break out of that. There's the trap. He splits the trap with the dribble move.
Starters, Persley, Ball, and West sitting on three fouls.
Yeah, that could be big, because Stinnie has three also. You know, mentioning Jacksonville, Bob Wentzel, when he was here, had that program really in high gear. Wentzel now an assistant coach with the Nets. There's Dinkins right now. Look at this. Little shake, spinning, whirling. Doesn't look pretty, but goes down. He goes to the deck. He says, count it. That's why I'm player of the year. Take a look at those stats.
Kind of numbers. 16 points tonight. Thompson hits the free shot.
But I was mentioning Wentzel. I know there's going to be a lot of jobs popping open now within the next week or two. Bob Wentzel would be a great. I think he belongs in college. I think he'd be a great choice in some college throughout America as a head coach.
Jeff West in. And Reggie Barnes goes up. Another free shot for John Thompson. He has hit 9 consecutive free throws. Make it 10. 8 points for Thompson, 57-54. The Rams keep hanging in there, Dick Bartek.
They keep hanging with big three, but they seem to always come up with the big play, as we said earlier, Charlotte. I love the way he takes command of the offense. He gets the kind of shots he wants his team to get. Just a little simple cut through, posted on the boxes.
Blocky, no, tip, VCU control.
Monty didn't have a good angle to release that. He was in poor position to shoot that ball.
Jakes for three to tie it.
We got a tie ball game. Trifecta.
First tie since 16-28 when we were 9-4. Now even at 57.
And they're jumping with joy here. A little rock and roll time in Richmond, Virginia. Listen to the crowd. Dinkins for three.
Yes!
Oh, he says, yeah, you hit your three, Mr. Cheeks, but what about my three?
He looked over at me a little bit because I said he can't shoot. 60-57,
49ers.
He's a scorer. He just flat out wants to get it done.
Stinnie. Thompson keeps it alive, but only to watch it go into the hands of Jeff West. Now here's Dinkins. Persley, baseline, rainbow for two.
Persley comes back again, and once again we have the answer. They tie to score, and they will not be denied. They keep coming back, coming back, coming back.
Hit five in a row. Cheeks for three, missed that one. Stinnie. Let's see which way they call it. It belongs to VCU.
Every time VCU seems to get them in a position where they're going to take command, immediately a big basket's made by Dinkins or by one of the inside players, Blonke.
The lob in through to Thompson. Wilson, a three-pointer. Got it.
Wilson and Chiefs driving out three in. We got ourselves a good one, Mr. Rathburn. We got ourselves
indeed.
A good one.
Those are the first two three-pointers for VCU in this game. 62-60.
And remember what's at stake. The trip to the NCAA plus the gold trophy of the Sun Belt Conference champ.
Dinkins driving.
Oh, great drive.
Now VCU kicks it out. They've got a 4-on-2. Cheeks.
Great execution. Clinic 101 and how to run the break. Good bounce pass. 45-degree angle cut. Dinkins got himself in poor position after making a superb drive for the goal. Monty's got him on his back. He's got him inside.
Martin Henlon, the guilty party, his third.
They don't take advantage of number 45's ability to post it up inside. Like Polio would rather see them that play better defense and not allow him to sit in that post.
Henlon and Stinnie now with three fouls for VCU.
Henlon, a role player, comes off the bench, a space eater, gives him size, a little physical play inside.
Reggie Barnes and Mike Washington back into the 49er lineup. Jeff West is out of the game, along with Cedric Ball, and Plonky rolls in the free shot.
Plonky out of Duke, Iowa. He's been all over the place, played junior college basketball at Central Arizona.
11 points for Plonky, and a timeout on the floor. 7:36 left in the Sun Belt Championship game. It's the 49ers leading VCU by two. Scoreboard story, 7:36 to play. 64 UNCC, 62 VCU. It's been a hot, heavy second half. Your fan club out full force here in Richmond, Virginia.
Well, you know, they're really excited here. About 1990, they're going to host the first two rounds. As we look right here, field goals in the second half. There's the percentages. You can see the numbers. But they're excited, VCU, that right here at the Richmond Coliseum, the first two rounds of the NCAA tournament will be here.
64-62, 7:36 remaining. The 49ers lead it by two after the free throws by Dan Plonky. Now the Rams bring it up. I know, Dick, you love this. Close game, 7.5 to go, and an NCAA bid hanging in the balance.
And a gold trophy for the trophy case.
Stinnie, a fadeaway. Bingo.
Big stars really rise to the occasion now. Now we should see the Stinnie Dinkins show down the stretch. Guys that want the rock. So many players leading the game, Bob, at a crunch time like this. They say, no, coach, don't give me the rock.
Persley, a three-pointer. Got it.
Persley wants the rock. He spaces up. So what about me, Vitale? I'm playing like a PT beer.
27% three-point shooter. Frank Persley puts the 49ers on top by three.
Now we throw away stats at this time of the year.
Cheeks, yes.
Cheeks making all the big plays in the perimeter.
VCU, Dick, has scored on 13 of their 19 possessions here in the second half.
That offensive efficiency rating when you chart a half-court execution like that is extremely high.
A one-point lead for the UNCC 49ers.
But he wants to screen. He points, give me the screen. They switch on the screen. Then he reverses the ball.
Out of the corner, Barnes. Strips the cord.
Well, what execution. They worked today at their shoot-around this afternoon on laying the screen, and if they switch on the screen, step back from the switch, and that's what they did there.
Hanlon. Rebound Thompson. Hanlon sticks it back in.
Hanlon with a good offensive rebound inside. Didn't look pretty at all shooting the jump shot.
And you can see, Dick, where VCU is starting to control that offensive board just a little bit.
That was the real concern of Jeff Mullins. A one-on-one move right here into the lane.
A floater for Dinkins.
Oh, he does a great job getting into the lane. They don't close off the driving angle, and he gets into an isolation on a 1-4 set.
Three-point lead for UNCC. 5:34 left. VCU gets another offensive rebound.
This is one heck of a championship. This is the way a winner's supposed to be. Earn it, baby. You got to earn this W. They're going to make him shoot that perimeter shot and try to take away his driving game. Look, Jeff Mullins dancing on the sideline.
You mentioned, Dick, how the stars shine down the stretch. Byron Dinkins, 27% shooting in the tournament, 50% tonight, and he's carrying this 49ers.
See, now he'll step off that screen. What they're doing is they're stepping out, switching on any screen action. Look at poise. He's got his head up, vision of the play.
It's a hold on Cheeks.
He's got all those clutch moves, double clutch. He dribbles a little high on his dribble, reminiscent of B.J. Armstrong over at Iowa. Like Julio's Bielox time, that stomach's churning. You know, he had, and I mean this in a very serious way, because I went through it as well. He had an ulcer problem last year, and he's hospitalized and missed some games from Mr. Polio. And I know how painful that could be. Believe me, that sent me to the sideline as well.
In a double team. And a steal by Vince Wilson. Dinkins behind him.
Oh, I don't know about maybe a little deliberate push. But they might have missed.
15 for Vince Wilson. It's a one-point game in favor of UNCC.
Wilson with the good anticipation, the steal, and the conversion.
Another key dig down the stretch. Only 14 fouls on VCU. It will be a while before the 49ers go to the bonus.
They can play a little aggressively on defense here.
Good, great.
And does he answer it? I can't believe it. Good balance, perfect shot. He loves the pressure. You can see it.
That had to be about a 28-footer. Bacon for three. Rebound to Washington.
Washington, big, strong body. Give it a number four. It's his show now. It's his dance. He says, fellas, I'm going to take you to the big dance. Just get me the rough. I love this bomb. I love it.
74-70, UNCC. Barnes to the bucket. And which way will it go? It's going to be an offensive foul on UNCC's Reggie Barnes.
Good job by the officials. They communicate with each other. They take a look and they get the call. I'm so impressed with Rutledge as an official. Doesn't need me to be impressed. This statistics when you look at it. 85 in the final, 86. Now watch the anticipation right here. Here's the steal. Now watch. Does he put a hand on him? Oh, he misses him. Beep.
That last offensive foul by Barnes took certainly a key swing. Charlotte had a chance to take a six-point lead. Now VCU can cut it to two.
Big four-point turnaround. Especially with this guy on the free throw line.
Fourth best in the Sun Belt at 82.6.
Usually at this time, they excel.
For Phil Stinnie.
Stars excel. If you look at Mike Polio, it's a tough time right now. He knows that this win is important to his program, and he wants to apply that knockout punch. Doesn't want the jury to look at those numbers and decide whether they get in a tournament or not.
20 points for Phil Stinnie, and it's a two-point game. 3:43 remaining in Richmond, Virginia, and we'll be right back. The conference tournament. 3:43 left. The home team on the board is UNCC. VCU, 72. Bob Rathman, Dick Vitale. Sun Belt Tournament Championship game. And the 49ers, led by the Sun Belt Player of the Year, that man right there, Byron Dinkins.
Dinkins outstanding tonight. Kevin Bilderman was right behind him, the assistant coach, and he was really breaking down in a scouting report as we look at a guard comparison right now with Cheeks and Dinkins. Pretty balanced right here. Dinkins 11 for 21, shooting really well here. Did not shoot well in the first two games of the tournament. But Bilderman did an excellent job at practice scouting and evaluating and breaking down all the things that VCU wants to do.
Jeff West into Dan Plotkin.
Now spacing becomes important to eliminate any kind of help. See how to get away from him? He can have a one-on-one move right here. Give it off if they give any help. Cheeks wants the challenge. He's going to play with Dinkins. He wants the challenge on him. Oh, good look.
Blocking. Fouled by Henlon.
But it was an excellent post speed by West. He did a super job bumping it back inside. Fourth foul right now on Henlon. But great entry to the post. As I said earlier, that's a very difficult pass to make. Watch right now. We're going to watch the excellent bounce pass. Good angle. He does a great job sealing off the defense. Not quick. Gets fouled. He wants the bounce. He looks pleased.
And Bonkey at the line. Puts in his 12 points. Vince Wilson is coming in for VCU, and Martin Henlon going out of the game.
They go for quickness, and they go for a shooter. He can shoot a three-point shot as well.
Lockie right on his average. Second-best free-throw shooter in the Sun Belt on the season. Puts them both in. 76-72 UNCC.
Over the top of the screen. Plotkin against Stinnie.
Stinnie foul by Plotkin.
Stinnie posting up inside. Plotkin gets behind, allows him that good low post position. Can't give him in. Can't handle a guy when you let him sit in the boxes like that.
And with his third, and Stinnie back to the foul line. 14 second half points for Phil Stinnie, 20 for the game.
You know, UNCC lost a heartbreaker over at Kentucky at Rupp Arena. They had them on a roach, baby. I mean, Rupp Arena was as quiet. This guy wasn't quiet at the end with a ball that was made. I don't know if you're familiar with that.
Yes.
At the end of that game. Very controversial loss. So they can play with the big boys.
Stinnie puts them both in. And pressure by VCU after the made free throw. Lockie back to West, 2:50 left.
Well, good reversal against the trap. One man lines up, one step off the wall. They think it's pulling out the play. Oh, they got a foul right there. Definitely knocks Dinkins down.
But Charlotte is not in the bonus.
Yeah. See, right now they can play a little bit more aggressively. That's the way I believe their fifth foul on a team concept. They still have another one to give before they're in the bonus.
2:36 remaining. Henlon returns. And Bacon out.
Yeah, they go for size right now. They bring Henlon in. He has four fouls.
Two-point lead for the 49ers and pressure. And they get it into Plotkin.
Every time they needed a big basket, they have come through and converted.
Loose ball. Still loose. DCU's got it. 4-on-2. Wilson firing.
Good play by Wilson. Pulls up under control. A lot of boys. Look at the fans right here. The Rams fans love it. High ball game. It's wire time, baby.
Oh, this is what you love if you're a fan of college basketball.
Enoch in time. Right now, all the big challenges. Look at Cheeks playing Dinkins. Here's the scream of Plotkin. And he rolls it. He missed him. Oh, get it to him quicker.
Wilson comes from behind and a foul.
One of the oldest plays in basketball. A very simple screen and roll. Take a look right there. 45 lays the screen. They switch. Now he rolls. He's pleated. He wants the ball. They rotate over, and there's the attack. You can put the foul on anybody you want inside.
1:57 left. Reggie Barnes returns. Cedric Ball in the game up front for UNCC. And Plotkin is at the line. Four fouls on Vince Wilson.
Next one, they're in the bonus. Both clubs will be in the bonus. Free throw shooter, 81%.
14 points for Plotkin. It's the 49ers on top, 77-76.
A lot of people down in Charlotte sitting here, nervous as can be, and also in Richmond.
I don't think they're sitting, Dick. I think they're on their knees or standing and pacing. It's 78-76.
Stinnie wants the ball. A little bit of Stars want the ball right now. He wants the ball, 35.
Monkey doing a great job. Here's Cheeks. Now Stinney's got it. Fires. Foul. Lockie got him on the arm, and that'll be the fourth on Dan.
And that's the guy you don't want on a free throw line. An excellent free throw shooter, Stinnie. Four on Dan Lockie.
78-76 UNCC. So now the pressure shifts to Phil Stinnie to connect at the free throw line. And again, the VCU substitution with Martin Henlon for Vince Wilson. A minute 35 remaining in the game.
So what they're trying to do is go offense, defense now with Henry Wilson.
Mike Washington in. Cedric Ball out for UNCC.
Washington, big, strong. Get your hands up. He's communicating. Going to be a leader on the floor. Good-looking shooter right here. Look at this. 8-for-8 on the free throw line. He'll convert these.
Money in the bank.
Oh! Why every time you do that? I can't believe it. All year long. Come on, Phil, you make me look bad.
The Dickey V jinx.
Wow.
So now it's a one-point game.
Well, I mean, 9 out of 10 thus far tonight, but maybe not enough.
But those misses certainly magnified in the final minutes of a close game.
Well, right now, shot selection becomes very important. Good timeout. Excellent timeout. Settle down. Go over the strategy as to what you're going to do.
Timeout, a minute 29 left. UNCC with the ball when we come back. With Dick Vitale, Bob Rathman back at the Richmond Coliseum. Minute 29 remaining, Sun Belt title game. And it's a one-point basketball game with UNCC in the lead, 78-77.
Basically right now, both clubs going over strategy and time. They're going over score. They're going over all the little things, matchups. People want to, you know, right now there's so much tension and emotion that goes on into a timeout. They want to make certain the coaches that every player knows exactly what's happening in terms of time right now on the clock, what strategy we want to run, matchups, foul situations. They're going to put the ball in the hands of Dinkins. There's no doubt about it.
There's the score. Now we're going to show you the two clocks. The shot clock is on the left at 39 seconds. The game clock on the right at a minute 29.
They're going to try to really deny the ball from Dinkins, number four. You watch right now. Cheeks is going to try to deny him the basketball. They want to now get the ball into his hands. They'll pop him out off the screen. There's the screen. They're holding him. They're holding him.
The hold on Chris Cheeks.
Yeah, they're holding. They're trying to deny him the ball. He tried to use the screen. There's a special art in reading the screen and how to come off the screen.
So now to the free throw line. Byron Dinkins of UNCC. He's 0-for-1 at the line tonight. He scored a game-high 24 points.
Look at his shooting from the free throw line. 90%.
It's a two-point lead for UNCC, 79-77, a minute 22 remaining.
He's a 73% shooter for the year, 90% shooting. I mean, you talk about clutch. Also right here, UNCC shooting well on that line as well.
26 for Dinkins, 80-77.
It was ice cool on that line, I'll tell you something. It was cool as could be.
Stinnie is wide open.
Can't let a star player like that open. He's going to knock that down 9 out of 10 times.
And VCU has taken the timeout. They have two timeouts remaining. A minute 10 left, 80-79, UNCC on top. Oh, this has been a dandy, and the next one coming up on ESPN, it's going to be the Metro Atlantic Championship, and that will be pitting Fordham against LaSalle.
Well, when you see LaSalle, the people, Lionel Simmons, remember that name. You talk about all the great players in America, Lionel Simmons can play with all the supers. There's so many kids that don't get the national recognition, the Brian Shaws of the world, of University of California, Santa Barbara, because of visibility. But let's get over here right now, and look at these Ram fans going bananas.
What's amazing, we talked about it. The stars will get the ball and make the big play. Dinkins goes to the free throw line. He bangs down both. Come down to the other end of the floor. Who knocks down the jump shot? Stinnie. It's amazing. The great players want the rock at pressure time.
Stinnie has scored 25 for VCU. Dinkins 26 for UNCC. And there's a one-point difference in the game.
Well, everything at stake right now. NCAA tournament first. Championship of the Sun Belt Conference. MVP trophy of the tournament. Who's going to get the gold? Will it be Stinnie or will it be Dinkins? It's got to go to the winner.
A minute 10 left. 80-79. UNCC.
Interesting to see the kind of strategy they've been pressuring all game long. They back out of the pressure right now. They let them come up the court. They go to what looks like a straight man-to-man. Maybe they're going to fall back in the zone. And they're going to fall out into the zone right now to take away the one-on-one ability of Dinkins.
The shot clock on the left is 31. Game clock at 55. Blonkey back out to Dinkins.
They go to a 1-3-1 set against the 2-3 zone. Go out even. Look at the diagonal open man. Skip pass, you were wide open.
Shot clock winding down. It's on the left of your screen. A one-point lead for UNCC.
The wings will be open if they reverse the ball to the wings or off the post. The wing shot will be there. Oh, they go right into the gut.
Blocky lost the ball. Hanlon's got it. Held ball possession, VCU.
VCU with the big play all game long. UNCC has been making the big play, the big score when they had to, but right now they lose possession. Up they go.
30 seconds left in the game.
Will he get a timeout or will he let them get the shot? See, here's where I would get myself a timeout when they get across the line and settle up. Yeah, there's the timeout. Good call.
Dick, VCU has scored on all of UNCC's turnovers this half. VCU just turned it over, and now UNCC is on defense with the Rams trying to score to take the lead. We'll see what happens right after these messages. There's Mike Polio. You see him at that VCU sideline. The Rams with the basketball. UNCC winless here against the Rams all time. And that goes back to the days of Cornbread Maxwell. 80-79. UNCC is leading the Rams to get it in.
Well, you know they're going to want to go to Stinnie. He's going to guide us, carry them all year long. Number 35. They can't telegraph it, though, into them. They're playing them tough defensively right now. Hursley playing them. He had a big defensive play yesterday in a win, Persley, number 35. Look, he wants him to get the good angle.
Another timeout for VCU with 11 seconds to go.
Well, down.
So the Rams are going to take one shot for the whole works.
Well, down one, I was just going to mention that, Bob. When you're down one like you are in this situation here, you don't want to take it to the buzzer. You want to give yourself an opportunity, if you miss, to have a little strategy involved. Maybe an offensive rebound, foul immediately, make them have to make the foul if they come over up with the ball so you get another shot. So you look to shoot the ball really with about 4 to 5 seconds so you have some time in the event you do not score.
Mike Polio talking it over with his Rams. Obviously, Dick, everybody's thinking about Bill Stinnie and taking that last shot. If Stinnie is covered, what's the next option for VCU?
Well, really, if Stinney's covered, Cheeks is a good driver, and he's got good ability to go to the basket with the ball. But right now, I think you got to get the angle to get him the ball. They were in a 1-4 set. He was trying to get them to get the ball to the wing because that's the entry you'd like. As you look at the timeouts remaining, none for VCU. Charlotte with three. But right now, I would look to get him the basketball right there, number 35. Great players have a way to get free for the rock.
It's a one-point lead for UNCC. We'll watch it with you.
You know, when a game was on the line, if you had Jerry West or Oscar Robertson, I don't care, the whole place knew they were going to get the ball. But you know what? They got the ball. See, right now, time going down. Stinnie down on those boxes.
Wilson. clock. He fouled by Stinnie with 1 second left, and the 49ers are on the threshold. It was not Phil Stinnie. It was Vince Wilson, and he missed.
Certainly not the kind of shot you would like to get after a designated timeout where you had a chance to set up a play. Wilson shooting an off-balance shot. Time was running down. They couldn't get the angle they wanted. Credit that to the defensive effort to Mullins and his team.
The one tick of the clock left, and VCU out of timeouts. They are really in a desperate situation.
Yeah, you're really hoping for the miracle right now. You got to foul immediately before time is not allowed. You have to watch out for the intentional foul because that's two shots in possession as well. So that's very important. But if you make a good effort to try and stop the ball, remember the clock does not start in college basketball until the ball touches a player on the floor.
A look at that last VCU shot.
See, right now he had Stinnie. Look at the angle. They missed Stinnie. He was determined to shoot it. If we were running that back, Stinnie is definitely open. There's the foul. Plunkey with the great rebound, number 45. But they had Phil Stinnie. He was definitely open. He had the defensive player on his back, but they never saw him. Not that he deliberately didn't want to give him the ball. They didn't see him.
Plunkey, a 1-1. Charlotte a two-point lead.
I missed the foul right there. See, I thought they had possession of the ball, but he missed the foul. He converts this now. Remember, the three-point shot and a desperation shot can tie it.
Bonke again. Missed it. That'll do it. Bacon. No good. The UNCC 49ers are the Sun Belt champions.
Jeff Mullins, Tom Poole, goes shakes Mike Polio's hand. What an outstanding game this was, Bob. Jubilation down in Charlotte. Celebration time, going to the NCAA Big Dance.
The 49ers win it over VCU. The disappointment etched on the faces of the VCU Rams. They cannot believe what's happened to them. VCU in Richmond.
What a way to get that first win here, too, with so much at stake. We talked about the championship trophy, the trip to the NCAAs. What a rebuilding job has been done by Jeff Mullins with this program. You think he feels pretty good right now? He looks like he's on cloud nine, and he has every right to be.
For Dick Vitale and our crew here in Richmond, Bob Rathbun saying so long.